Hey, Brett McFall here. How are you today? Truly, how are you? Are you good? Are you enjoying the teaching that I'm giving you? Hopefully you are, because this is the really good stuff. I'm on a mission to try and make this as simple as possible for you. I'm trying to think about what you're thinking of, what you need, and put that into the actual videos that I'm creating for you, so that, you know, should you want to become a coaching student of mine, you have a fair idea that I really am going to teach you well and teach you so that it sticks. And if it sticks, you'll be able to get some results. Okay, so that's how I teach. So now is a very exciting part that I want to teach you right now, is how to do the opportunity section of your presentation. This is where, you know, we transition from a journey into, hey, if you want to know more, here's what you can do, here's where we can go. This is the payoff for you. This is where all the dollars start to come into your bank account. So let me talk to you about how it's done. Let me give you some examples of how to do it, so that you can start and change your presentation too. All right, that'd be cool. This is really important stuff. Because time spent on this, you know, you can turn this into an automated presentation here at some point. So this becomes an asset. Your presentation becomes an asset. But it's this part, the opportunity section, which is the asset part, because this is what makes the sales happen, all right? Let me go to my computer now and let me show you how to get started with your opportunity section, all right? Let me show you how to do this. Let's go.
So let's talk about part three, the opportunity. You've got your message right. You've got your journey right. Then the opportunity is where people excitedly want to go further with you. But there's a way to do it and a way not to do it. Most people, most presenters don't do it the right way. They still make some sales, so they think they're doing it the right way, but they're missing out on so many sales, they don't realize how much they're missing out on. The question to ask is, what is the opportunity you want to give? Not what do you want to sell? That's a different question. What is the opportunity you want to give people? The opportunity to learn more, do more, be more, have more. What is the opportunity you want to give people? Because people, your audience, love opportunities to do better, be better. So you're going to be the provider of opportunities, okay? And let's just think about this in its real form. Is the opportunity you want to give like online coaching? Okay, that's very popular these days. Is it a live seminar or a webinar? Is it in-person coaching, you know, one-on-one, or one-to-five, one-to-many? Or is it a done-for-you process? You need to be very clear on exactly the opportunity that you want to give. And you might think, well, Brett, I have so many things in my coaching program, so many ways. They've got DVDs, they've got CDs, they've got MP3s, they've got MP4s, they've got coaching calls, they've got webinars, they've got seminars, they've got workshops, they've got Q&A nights. Okay, I get it. The whole thing's the opportunity, right? But what is the opportunity you want to give? What is the core thing you want to give someone? What's the core thing you want to give them? And the rest can be added bonuses, okay? What's the core thing? It's almost like going back to your message. What's the one thing? Okay, so a tip is, know what the audience wants most. And this might involve some you having to do some research, actually talking to attendees, and I'm sure you do and have, I get it, but talking to them in a way to completely receive what they're feeling, not to interpret what they're saying and put it in your own words, but to completely feel, completely understand what they're sensing, what they're feeling. So for instance, often it can be actually very simple. If you are doing this presentation on a webinar, then the audience is more likely to want more webinars. They're already watching a webinar, okay? If you are doing this, your presentation via an online video, so it's recorded, let's say, people are more inclined to want to watch more online videos like that. They're already telling you their learning modality. They're already telling you, I'm happy learning this way. If you're in a seminar or a workshop, chances are that audience predominantly will want more seminars or workshops. They're already telling you, this is how we like to learn. And I see so many people come along and they go to, let's say, a seminar and they want to offer people software. And there's a disconnect. Not that it doesn't sell. I've seen software outsell every product offered during any seminar I've run. I've seen it happen. But of course, the software related to what they wanted to do. So it made sense. But just be very clear that mostly when they're seeing your presentation, that's generally how they want to actually receive your learning as well. Isn't that cool? It's actually not that hard, right? Another tip would be, make your offer as easy to understand as the journey section. So if you're not good at this, maybe you understand your offer. So take your offer, take it to some children that you know, maybe it's your own children, or someone who's completely outside of your industry, and go through your offer. Ask them, can I pay you if I have to? Just sit there while I go through my my opportunity for you. And have them tell you how they feel about what you've just said. And if they're asking questions like that indicate that things aren't making sense to them, you've got a massive problem. It's not the fact that you understand it perfectly that matters. It's whether they understand it perfectly. So make it easy to understand. Make it easy and easy. Which usually means putting things into sections. Breaking things up. People can accept things in chunks. They find it hard to accept everything at once. In terms of like everything bundled in at once. But breaking things up so they have time to accept them. Understand them. Fall in love with them. Then another thing. Then another thing. So there's a way to do that, right? But it must be made easy to understand. If you ever go into McDonald's, everything on their food menu on the board is very easy to understand. Go to a place that's similar, a burger place that's similar, run by a mum and dad, and they generally don't understand how to make things easy. They've got stuff written in text, stuff made with professional letters, made stuff with paper stuck on it. With this is now this price has changed to that, and we have a special on today, and it's all confusing. It's all about making things easy to understand. And if you can't do it, find somebody who can, have them rework your presentation to make it easy. Then suddenly your sales will improve and you won't even realize how that happened. You'll go, what? It's the same as it was before. But no, it's not from your prospect's point of view. Okay? Another tip. Have plenty of proof that your opportunity works. This is the thing which a lot of people just don't have. Maybe they don't realize. Maybe they don't think they need it because they're such a good presenter. They don't think they need it. But you do need it no matter how good you are. People like to see proof, and not your proof, other people's proof. So if you don't have much proof. Get some stats, get some successes under your belt, all right? Have plenty of proof that your opportunity works. Testimonials, before and afters. And if you're going to do testimonials or before and afters, make sure you use full names and suburbs or any other detail you can possibly get from them so they actually look real, all right? Well, they have to be real, but it's important they look real as well, as in full name disclosure. Some of my testimonials actually provide their phone numbers. It's unbeatable proof. And that makes people feel very secure that, okay, I know, I'm sure that person on stage can do it, but what about me? Okay, so there's some other people who were like me and they've been able to do it. That makes me feel better, right? Makes sense. Tip, have a guarantee that will hurt you, not them. And you're having a guarantee on your coaching program or your ebook or whatever it is you sell is no big revelation. But there's guarantees and there's guarantees. A regular guarantee says, look, you know, you have complete satisfaction here. If you're not happy, let us know. We'll refund you in full. And it sounds like a good guarantee. And it is. But you have to change the game and do things the new way, not the old way. Have a guarantee that will hurt you if something goes wrong, if they don't like the program. Have it hurt you, not them. They can't hurt in any way. They must win or win. They simply cannot lose. That's the story you're going to get across. So let me give you an example here. Here's a guarantee that I use for one of my programs called Help Me Day, where I do a live training over one day. Here's what it says. Here is why this is a safe investment. My risk-free, 100% total satisfaction guarantee. You have zero risk if you attend the day and don't think it's worth twice what you invest, as in twice what they invested. I'll refund your money in full, plus give you $500 on top as a thank you. And note how that's worded, as a thank you. And then this next wording is even more important. We will part as friends, and you walk away $500 richer. So it lets them know that, hey, there's no uncomfortableness here. It's totally fine. And you walk away $500 richer just for taking a chance. Bottom line is, you can only win. I always make sure they understand this. You can only win. You can only come out on top. I want you to be happy no matter what. So that achieves a few things. A, it lets them know what the deal is, and a very good deal. But it also lets them know your intentions, that you are truly striving to do the right thing by them. And you've got to live up to this course, right? You've got to live up to it. I'm sure you're a good person. I'm sure you will live up to it. But this is what makes people feel secure. And these days of, you know, being online, people can, you know, trash you without any identity having to be shown. So it's very important that you do, you know, make sure that people win or win, because they'll talk about that as well, and you'll become a bit of a hero, right? Another tip. Do this. This is awesome. Crush the number one objection in your viewer's mind about joining you. Because while people listening to your presentation, they are thinking all the time, They're asking questions all the time. So your big goal is to crush, in the opportunity section, the in section, the close, crush the number one objection in your viewer's mind, not that it's valid, but in their mind about joining you. Usually, it's that they don't believe that they can achieve the results you're promising. They tend to think, and they might say it like this or say it in a similar way, they think generally though, it's okay for you, because you're the star, you're the expert, that's why you're on stage, that's why you're doing a webinar, but for me, I'm not sure. So if we know that's in their mind, we have to crush it. We have to crush it, which means answer the objection. Before they even raise it, just take it head on. So for example, explain to them, you know, I was once where you are, and I didn't think I could achieve what I have either. That's letting them know that you're once like them. But if you can just follow a simple step-by-step process, then you too can reach a goal. So now it changes it from this big challenge to all I'm going to do is follow a step-by-step process, which is the reality. And it just minimizes the pain. It's like, okay, well, I can probably follow a process. And it's money-back guaranteed too. So, you know, it's seeming easier and easier to make this decision. But it's important to notice and to acknowledge that what their objection might be. Number one objection, crushed in the opportunity. You tackle it head on. You might say, most people think that they can't do this. Well, let me talk about that. Or whatever that number one objection is, okay? Here's another tip. Are you ready? Hope you're taking notes, right? Make your offer irresistible. For an example here is like, what are the thing or the things they want the most? I think my English there is a bit incorrect, actually. What is the thing or what are the things they want the most? Okay. You've got to be able to answer that question. What do they want the most? Think about what they want, not what you want to give them. Think about what they want, and if you don't know, you need to find out. But that's how you make your offer irresistible. If you give people exactly what they want, you make lots of money, you have yourself a good business. You're in the business of giving people what they want. Now you give them your advice along with what they want, but it has to be in the medium they want, you know, in the style they want. That's how people happily give you their money, if you give them what they want. Just like you, you're a customer at some point. You want stores to give you what you want. You want restaurants to give you what you want. That's the transaction. So make sure what you think is a good offer, it might be a good offer. I'm sure you've made some money with it. But is it irresistible? Where people, if they don't buy, they feel, oh, it's silly not to buy. I know it's not. I know it, I really should be buying it. That's how they should be feeling, because that's how good it should be. Now, they may have real reasons for not joining. It might not be the right time, the right price, or whatever. But everyone should feel, gee, that's a really good offer. That's a really good offer. They should be emotionally impacted by the offer. It's that good. That's the goal. So what can you do? What can you give? What can you add that would just make people go, wow, I'm in. I'm so in. All right. The goal. To summarize this, the goal of the opportunity section is to create a table rush. And a table rush might be everybody in your webinar ordering straight away, or it might be a rush to the actual table at the back of a room at a seminar, or, you know, a client signing up on the spot. The goal is to create a table rush because your audience sees, they see exactly what their life will be like after they have your program. There's no confusion. They know, hold on, if I join now, if I buy now, if I invest now, oh, I'm going to experience this benefit, that I already can already see how that life's going to be. And that's what I want. I want to have that result. I want to have that outcome. If you can help them see the outcome, and other speakers doing things the old way are clouding their vision. In fact, that, you know, the audience isn't opening their eyes, isn't even opening their eyes to the possibility of going with these folks, then this is how you get a table rush in various ways, okay? Very cool, right?